So the goal for the design challenge is to design and build a helicopter that can take a payload of one penny, fly it 10 feet in the air, and stay up for at least 3 seconds.
Now that we know what our design challenge is, let's learn about a few things that will help make our helicopter work. Once you build a body for your helicopter, you should connect it to a rubber band and a propeller.
So the first thing you're going to do is to wind the propeller up about 50 turns. What you're doing there is you're adding energy into the rubber bands.
Don't worry if it looks like your rubber band might snap. By winding up the rubber band, you are storing energy, and the stored energy will help create a lot of thrust. This thrust will help your helicopter fly upwards. Now, what else do we need to think about?
The timing is important because the rotor has to be spinning and generating thrust before you let go of the body.
Let's follow David's directions. We need to let go of the propeller so it will start spinning a few seconds before we let go of the body of the helicopter.
The second concept is when you release the propeller, you want the energy in the rubber band to turn the propeller, and turning that propeller is going to generate thrust that's going to keep your helicopter in the air.
Now, we know that the propeller is going to generate thrust, and that timing of releasing the propeller is important to lift the helicopter up. What's next?
You want the body right at the bottom, where the paperclip is, and you want it to be even on either side, so that the weight balance is equal on each side.
When you add your penny to the body of the helicopter, make sure it is still balanced. If it is not balanced, it will not be able to fly straight up like a real helicopter. Ready to design an innovative helicopter? Start inventing on Curiosity Machine.